Six, five, four, three, two, one. Ignition. And liftoff. Liftoff of Falcon Heavy with Europa Clipper, unveiling the mysteries of an enormous ocean lurking beneath the icy crust of Jupiter's moon, Europa.
Engine chamber pressures are nominal.
See that the chamber pressures are nominal as we hear. All 27 Merlin engines look great.
Rocket beginning to roll. Putting down 5.1 million pounds of thrust. Coming up, they're going to back off those engines just a bit.
So we're getting ready to head into max
power and telemetry nominal.
We hear that power and telemetry on the vehicle are good there. Everything's looking really
Falcon
well.
Falcon Heavy is supersonic.
They have reduced power in the center core to get through maximum dynamic pressure on the launch vehicle. As we approach that, the two side boosters at full throttle.
A beautiful shot there is our camera team.
Max Q.
Locking into the rocket on a clear blue sky. The view from the booster cam back down on Earth.
And there we heard the call for Max-Q. The vehicle is passing through maximum dynamic pressure. Next thing up in about 2 minutes will be a booster engine cutoff, where we see the two side booster engines, all 18, shut down and get ready for booster separation. But the vehicle is performing very well. Looking at all the telemetry that we have, power and trajectory are nominal.
We've been flying for just under 2 minutes so far. Everything looking good. B-side boosters, once they do their job, they will be expended. If you're familiar with the Falcon Heavy, you know that they bring the boosters back on certain launches, but not on this one, because all of the performance is needed to push Europa Clipper into its proper orbit.
Things continue to look good as the vehicle heads down its ascent phase here. All telemetry is looking very nominal for this flight this morning. Falcon Heavy is performing very well.
Now we're just about 30 seconds away from separating those side boosters. Their engines will cut off first, then they will separate.
MVAC is chilling.
Starting to chill down that MVAC-D engine in the second stage.
And that's where we need to get the engine chilled to the proper temperatures before flowing liquid oxygen and RP-1 into it. So they're conditioning the engine to make sure things are ready for when it's ready to start up.
Stand by for booster separation.
Booster engine cutoff. Side booster separation confirmed.
And there they go.
Those two boosters previously flown on Psyche, this will be their sixth flight. We thank you for their service this morning. They did a great job of getting Falcon Heavy and Europa Clipper on its way as the center core takes over and continues mission down its ascent. Things are looking really good in the telemetry. Power and trajectory look nominal, and chamber pressures on the 9 center core engines look really good.
In just a little more, 20 seconds from now, we'll get the cutoff of the main engine on the center core booster that remains. 4 seconds after that, we will separate. Flying out over the Atlantic Ocean. There's a look from inside.
There we see stage one.
Stage separation confirmed.
And stage separation from the center core. Getting ready for MVAC startup, SES-1.
We're getting some applause here in the Mission Director's Center, and there you see the MVAC-D engine lighting up.
Next thing up in about 10 seconds will be fairing separation.
NYPY FTS has saved.
And the fairing has protected Europa Clipper on its ascent up into space, but once we get into space, we don't need that fairing anymore.
Fairing separation confirmed.
Fairing has separated, and those will be recovered, Daryl, by SpaceX's own recovery ship, Go Cosmos.
And there you see them falling away into space. That is the only part of this rocket that will be recovered.
The glow of the MVAC-D engine as it performs its first burn here. This is about a 3 minute and 47 second burn. Things are looking great. Matter of fact, this is one of the shortest first burns that has been done on a Falcon Heavy by SpaceX, but it is required to get us into that parking orbit for that long coast that we have to get ready for the interplanetary trajectory that we're going to need to get Europa Clipper on its way that we heard Jenny talk about to get those Earth assist slingshots as it heads on its way for its mission. So things looking really good this morning with the performance of the Falcon Heavy. MVAC is performing well, and everything looks good thus far in today's mission.
Usually those burns are the other way around, with a longer first burn and the shorter second burn, but in this case, it is reversed. As we look at some crystal clear views of the MVAC-D engine, the Stage 2 that's carrying Europa Clipper, orbital